In this video, I'm going to get you started in DaVinci Resolve and setting up a project. This is actually very similar to what we did previously. If you've watched on my channel, we have several Audacity videos where it's the same concept. You're going to have a folder for storage of your working file for DaVinci, but also all of the assets that you're going to utilize when you're creating your video projects. So what I'm going to go ahead and do here is I'm actually just going to, again, on the desktop for time's sake, I'm going to call this my DaVinci project. Now, when you open DaVinci Resolve, it's going to pop up, and you can see I actually have a couple of other projects going on, but you do have Untitled Project. And then down in the lower right-hand corner, you have New Project or Open. So I'm going to go ahead and generate a new project. Normally, again, you get the untitled side of things. So let's call this my first video project. That's what we'll call it. And we'll say create. All right. Now, the first thing I'd like to talk to you a little bit about is just the interface regarding what you can do as far as DaVinci is concerned. First off, you have the main menu bar going across the top here, including things like your file dropdown, where, for example, I can save my project. So I'm going to go ahead and choose that first to save my project. Also, to remember, you can do a save project as, and it'll save it as a copy. Now, the other thing that I want to draw your attention to is you almost have two menu bars going on here. You've got the main menu bar going across the top here as far as the overall projects and just different options. We will get into those. But then if you look at the bottom of DaVinci, they have several additional options here where you have the media area as far as pulling in specific media elements that you can look at or you can access via your computer. And then really you have the cut areas as far as looking at the media and previewing it. We'll get to that in a later video. This is also where you can add some effects and transitions. And then you have the editing area where you can come through and use editing tools such as the selection, the blade, and so on and so forth to make clips and cuts between your video pieces. Now, it also offers, DaVinci that is, offers a fusion area as far as setting up different types of modifications as far as special effects and just general white balancing, like fixing the video. Like other multimedia areas such as photography or image creation, that is one thing you want to pay attention to is if you are filming or taking a video of your own work, it doesn't matter how much editing you do, a poorly recorded piece of video is still a poorly recorded piece of video. Always keep that in mind. It's kind of like audio in that sense, is you can try to do as much editing as possible. This is why, like audio, we do multiple takes in the realm of taking video. Even just using your phone, having a tripod can go a long way to deal with the shaking. Also, when you're using a phone, film horizontally, not vertically like you would see in a TikTok. Those are the types of things that you can kind of pay attention to as far as the design goes. More specifically too, you also have color as far as editing the color, the white balance of the overall video. So these here, like fusion, color, and fairlight, these really get into the nitty-gritty controls that are available to you in DaVinci Resolve. As far as fairlight is concerned, this is more audio as far as checking loudness controls as far as the overall sounds, making sure that you know you're in the green, so on and so forth. Last item, just to point it out to you, is delivery mode. You'll see the preview of your content here, but then also you can do either a custom export or you can go through and choose specific export options. You can even come on the drop down here for YouTube and you can choose different types of resolutions if you so choose. Now, I'll go into these in a little bit more detail in a bit. One other thing that I want to point out to you is like going back to cut, for instance. Under the workspace options here, if at any point in time you maybe click or close something, this is going to be the drop down here that you're going to want to use. For instance, if you go all the way down, you can reset UI layout. I like to point this out to folks who are just brand new to a software package because we've all done it where you accidentally hit the X button or you accidentally move and close something out, but you can't remember what you closed out exactly. So this is the location here to actually go in and just reset your layout here. Outside of that, I also like to point out in case of for those who are a little bit more intermediate advanced, under the DaVinci Resolve, you have two items I like to point out, which first off is the keyboard customization, where if you prefer, you can come in and set as far as according to what you would like for each of your keyboard shortcuts. I know some folks that whenever they do come in, they'll click on this drop down here. For example, students that I have that are more familiar with Adobe Premiere Pro, they'll often switch over to the Premiere Pro shortcuts just from experience there. I am going to assume that people have not worked in Premiere Pro for my videos, so I'm going to stay under the DaVinci Resolve keyboard shortcuts. But I like to point that out just in case. You also have preferences as well, where it's going to let you know as far as, you know, what memory and usage, what is your media storage, also a general area as far as what type of precisions you want to use. Letting it automatically check for updates is a good thing. All sorts of different options here that you may need as far as working in DaVinci Resolve here. You are more than welcome to go through and kind of look at these as far as each of the individuals here, as far as you can go between the overall system, but the user as well. All those sorts of items you can work with. So I'm going to cancel out of this. And that's just the bare bones of working and kind of introducing you to all of the different bits and pieces. You do not need to use every single element that I just showed you here. Honestly, you can get a ton done just by using cut, edit, and deliver. So keep that in mind moving forward with our videos here, but hopefully this gave you just kind of a good tour overall as far as DaVinci Resolve is concerned.